The Lord chose him for himself as high priest, and opening his treasure house, made him rich in all good things. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Good morning, everybody. We enter into this Mass, giving thanks to God for this gift and for the grace to be able to worship the Lord. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, may He forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let's pray. Almighty ever living God, who chose St. John Paul the Great to preside over your own people and benefit them by word and example, keep safe, we pray, by his intercession, the shepherds of your church, along with the flocks entrusted to their care, and direct them in the way of eternal salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, a reading through the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. This is what I pray, naked before God, from whom every family, whether spiritual or natural, takes its name. Out of his infinite glory, may he give you the power, through his Spirit, for your hidden self to grow strong, so that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. And then, planted in love and built on love, you will, all saints, have strength to grasp the breadth and the length, the height and the depth, until, knowing the love of Christ, which is beyond all knowledge, you are filled with the utter fullness of God. Glory be to Him, whose power, working in us, can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory be to Him from generation to generation in the Church, and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
This is the word of the Lord. Rest from story of Sam. The response is, the Lord fills the earth with His love.
The Lord fills the earth with His love.
Bring out your joy to the Lord, O you just, for praise is fitting for royal hearts. Give thanks to the Lord upon the harp, with a 10-string lute, sing him songs.
The Lord is with you.
For the word of the Lord is faithful, and all his works to be trusted. The Lord loves justice and right, and fills the earth with his love.
The Lord is with
you. His own design shall stand forever. The plans of his heart from age to age. They are happy whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own. The Lord looks on those who revere him, on those who hope in his love, to rescue their souls from death, to keep them alive and calm. Please stand for the gospel proclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Anyone who follows me will have the light of life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory
to you. Jesus said to his disciples, I have come to bring fire to the earth, on high I wish you were blazing already. There is a baptism I must still receive, and how great is my distress till it is over. Do you suppose that I am here to bring peace on earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. For from now on, a household of five will be divided, three against two, and two against three. The father divided against his son, son against father, mother against daughter against mother-in-law against mother-in-law, against daughter-in-law, daughter-in-law against mother-in-law. The Gospel of the Lord. For anybody or any priest, unless they're telling fibs, most of them will deliver the gospel and think, oh, just skip past that. This makes me just a little bit too uncomfortable. And that's kind of how I feel about today's gospel. Do you suppose that I'm here to bring peace on earth? No, I tell you, but rather division. I have come to bring fire to the earth. Son against father, father against son, mother against daughter against mother, and so on. And you know, I struggle to get grasp what Jesus is getting at, but what the gospel writer is talking about. And the only thing that I, the only conclusion I draw is the cost of discipleship is heavy. Really, really heavy at times. Because I'm not even saying, I guarantee every single person in this church today has at least one family member, like myself, perhaps multiple, who don't believe in God, who don't believe in Jesus, who act probably quite resentful of the church. And that's really, really hard. And to say that we put Jesus before family is what we're called to do. And that's incredibly difficult. We pray for our loved ones, we pray for our family. But Jesus is telling us, I think, that the cost of following him could mean division even in your own household. And that's what we need to pray. We need to hold tightly to the Lord and his truth and his mercy. That if we stick close to Jesus, Jesus will stick close to us, and our family members, our friends, will come to know him as Lord and God. Jesus also says, I've come to bring fire to the earth, and I have to do so, but I'm still not missing that day. But we will pray, Father, we come to stay close to him this morning in this Mass. Stay convicted of his love for us. And we call to mind all those members of our family who don't know Jesus, who are far from him in his church. Lord, hear us. We pray for the happy repose of the soul of David Kettle and of the Siegel, who passed away yesterday. We pray for his wife, children, grandchildren, and extended family. David's funeral mass will take place tomorrow in St. Congo's at 10 a.m. So the 10 a.m. Mass is cancelled for the public tomorrow because of the restrictions on funerals and things. So there will be no public 10 a.m. Mass, just the funeral Mass for the immediate family of Mr. Campbell. Eternal rest, grant unto him, O Lord, and let the perpetual life shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful depart him, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Lord, our Father, hear our prayers that we make to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. St. John Paul the Great, pray for us. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
In the mystery of this water and wine may we come to share, in the divinity of Christ and humble himself to share in our humanity.
Blessed be you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hand. It will become our spiritual drink.
Watch for you, Lord, for my pleasing cancer.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, Lord, and make what is offered for your glory and honor of St. John Paul a means to eternal salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have created in the company of your saints, and in crying in their merit, you crying your gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, share support. So that encouraged by so great a crowd of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us. And win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so, with the angels and archangels, and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy,
holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, Lord, all these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them as you come, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time was betrayed and willingly into his passion. He took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Keep this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Noel, our Bishop, and with all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John Paul II, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify for your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command and power by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, we said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. But God of our sins, build the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. This may be the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Good shepherd has laid out his life for his sheep. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, Lord our God, stir up in us that fire charity with which St. John Paul II regarded him, as he gave himself to season to your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a reminder about our member day list, to leave them in the box or through the parochial houses, and you write them out yourself, or you can get a copy on the Facebook page or the parish website as well. And just another reminder that Mass tomorrow is cancelled. So if you do speak to anybody who maybe would hope you go to Mass tomorrow, just maybe let them know that there is no Mass tomorrow morning. But Mass is as normal here in St. Joseph's Parish at 7 o'clock. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the hour of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God to shame in the holy bread, and the light of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast out of hell Satan, and with all evil spirits who wander through the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen. The Lord be with you,
and may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.